Leos, and welcome to your horoscope for July of 2020, and happy birthday. Look, nobody lets me know it's birthday time like the Leos, and I love you guys for it. I have a little Leo at home, so just happy, happy, happy birthday, Leo. This is your annual reset. This is like, ta-da, let's Leo some more. And this is the space where you get to decide, what do I want to do next? What do I want to set up in my next year? What am I looking forward to? Where are the goals? All of that good stuff gets to happen for you right now. So happy birthday. I can't wait to see what you do with your next year. Now this month, Leo, I got to tell you, as we're traveling through the month of July and I was looking at the horoscope, I want to bring your attention immediately to some things that are in the favor as we come forward into the month. First of all, we do have Mars in the energy of Aries, and this is a fellow fire energy. So the movement at birthday time is on you. You've got it. It's action oriented. It's like, yes, let's do this, or no, let's not. It's a very direct energy. And I think that that is something that maybe this Leo fire has been waiting for a while, because we've been kind of walking in the water. And so now there's an opportunity with our actions and our movements to be very decisive. Now, the other thing I keep thinking of is, because Mars is this fellow fire energy, you could really be the hot ticket item this month. When there is a fellow fire bonding going on, typically it's like you're attractive and it's birthday time and you've got this decisive magnetic moving energy going for you. So if there are decisions to be made or there are opportunities that come up for you this month, Leo, I would say definitely consider them wisely, but be prepared to take them. You might genuinely be on fire this month. So that is good, good, good news, I think. All right, Leo, let's jump in and let's talk about what's happening this month. Now, right at the beginning of the month, as we come in, we're coming in July 1st to a Saturn retrograde, but it's backing up back into the energy of Capricorn. Now, this lights up your sixth house space. Now, what I love about this energy is, first of all, because it's going back into Capricorn, you've seen this. You've been working on this. This is nothing new for you. You've been looking at this for a couple years, at least a year. And certainly since January, you've been looking at any shifts that have been happening in the sixth house. Now, the sixth house, it's about work. It's daily routines. It's your health. It is service to other people. Small pets fall in here as well. But in this particular area of getting organized, getting the daily routine, the daily hustle, the daily shuffle, the daily how you care for yourself, you've been working on this. So as Saturn comes back into this area, one of the things it may say is, okay, Leo, where do you need to amp up the self-discipline? Where do you need to pull this back in? Self-discipline, we've been in quarantine. Haven't you been over there snacking your eyeballs off, right? Like, what have you been doing while we've been in quarantine time? How are you interacting with your daily routines to care for yourself? So where do you need to get more organized? Where does there need to be a little bit more discipline? And I am seeing here too, because we are going to have a lunar eclipse happening on the 5th. Which will also light up the Capricorn energy, right? So this is going to bring to the table an ending. So for some of you, what I'm seeing here, especially if you employ other people, you may see some employee turnover happening at this particular time. It's like the Saturn retrograde moving back into Capricorn, plus the lunar eclipse that says that something needs to be ended, acknowledged, and adjusted. It's kind of doing a clean out here. So if you do employ people, you could expect people to be kind of moving out. Now, if you do not employ people, but in the area of your work, this could be shifts and job changes that are happening. Not necessarily that you're losing a job, or that you're going to another job. These are, of course, all possibilities, especially at an eclipse. And that could happen over this next 6 months. But something that could just be happening is the daily routine of work, like what you do at work is significantly different. This could be a time where, you know, coming off of all of the COVID stuff, are you going back into the office for the first time? And now there are all of these practices and these things that you need to do on a daily basis in order to be at work. But this could also bring changes to your health routine, health regimen, and things like that in terms of how you are caring for yourself. But this lunar eclipse plus the Saturn retrograde at this point are saying over the next 6 months, Leo, let's tighten up the discipline here. Make sure this is as good and as delicious and as high integrity as this area of your life can possibly be, okay? This is also really great for freelancers. If you do freelance work or contract work, this may be great for you as well because, again, you're a hot ticket item. So people may think that you are very disciplined. They like the way you are doing things, and this could bring some work your way. So that's good news. All right, on the 11th, we're going to see Chiron, our wounded healer, taking a retrograde until December. Now, because Chiron is this wound to us, this hole in our soul, and he's traveling over here in the energy of Aries, which lights up your ninth house space. Ninth house, publishing, marketing, broadcasting, higher learning, teaching, international business, travel, any of these things that expand you out, faith and beliefs, right? Ideas, ethics, morals, law, they all live in the ninth house. But as Chiron is traveling retrograde here in Aries, this is about your identity. And this is your identity, Leo, in an expanded way. Your identity outside of just your home. What are you known as, right? What do you do? What do you share? What do you teach? Do you have more training that needs to come to the table for you to kind of mold your life around this new identity that you have? So much has been shifting and changing. It's birthday time for you right now. You're deciding what you want for this next year. What needs to be healed here, right? In this hole in the soul around your identity in this particular area. Now, one of the things I will tell you is to thine own self be true, Leo. Do you. And every single one of us gets guilty of molding a little bit more to the herd than is always necessary, right? So we're here with this Chiron retrograde. Do you need to go back to that place where you're like, no, that's not really me. This is really me. Where are you accepting or having a challenge accepting yourself as you are, Leo? All of this energy gets the opportunity to be worked out at a soul and cellular level, I think, as well, while Chiron is retrograde until December. Now, on the 12th, we've got Mercury, who's in the energy of Cancer and retrograde right now, coming out of retrograde. So Mercury will be direct as of the 12th. But as always, you have to let Mercury have his cosmic latte, wake up, get his life together before you start being like, Mercury, bring me my blessings, right? Just let Mercury ease into his orbit and get moving in this direct fashion. Again, remember the stationing day, the 12th, is usually the day that is the most intense. We can expect challenges and issues, right? Now, in the energy here of Cancer, this continues to light up the 12th house space where the sun is still traveling here through the 12th house as well, with Mercury. So there's a lot of feels, there's a lot of emotions, there's a lot of deep connection to the past or things that are in between worlds. The 12th house has very easy access to the space that's in between the worlds. So I would think here, with Mercury coming direct this day, this is a phenomenal day in the 12th house for research. If you've been looking for information, if you've been looking to study, you want to study something spiritual, you want to do writing on something spiritual, you have case studies that you're working on, my detectives, I love this energy for you because this is really good for cold case investigations as well. But if you are looking for anything that's kind of between the worlds, as Mercury's direct here, the sun is shining down, this is a wonderful energy for you to investigate this area. Now, some of the investigation that happens as well is just that self-investigation, right? Where am I at on my spiritual path? Do I feel grounded? Do I feel connected? Do I feel forgiving? Do I feel like I have a space that lives between here and my head of unconditional love for myself and others? Do I accept my creativity here? There's a lot that is spinning and burning, and the sun is giving the motivation to this Mercury now direct. So this is a time where you can make decisions on what you want to do in this area to carry you forward. I also think that this is a time that during the Mercury retrograde, maybe your head and your heart felt like they were in a little bit of confusion, and now the head and the heart start to get into alignment. And this is a very long journey, if you know what I'm talking about. Now, on the 20th, we've got the new moon happening at 28 degrees of Cancer. So again, we've got to light up to this 12th house space, plant those seeds of intention for what you would like here. Know that Mercury and the sun are in your favor. And get ready, because just a couple days down the road, we're going to see the sun moving into the energy of Leo, and boom, it's birthday time. So happy, happy birthday again, Leos. The sun brings light, heat, life, and vitality. It is also your ruling energy. So this is like, boom, creative potential, expression, movement, magnetism, all the Leo, all the style, all of it comes right to your front door. So this is a beautiful energy for you to rock, to look at any patterns that maybe have been holding you back. You got to look at those in the 12th house, and now you look at them here in the first house and say, not today, I don't think so. I am Leo, hear me roar, and you get to trudge your path forward creatively with lots of light, lots of big heart, lots of Leo, and lots of love. So I think it is going to be a really nice birthday month for you. Still plenty of things happening. Turns and shifts, things that need to fall out will definitely be happening this month. What's trying to fall away from you, let it fall. It's the universe saying, this doesn't belong in my balance anymore. So all right, Leos, I think it's going to be a good birthday month. Like this video, comment, share, subscribe. Send me some comments in the comment section down below. Let me know, what are your plans for your birthday? What does the next year look like for you? Keep me posted in the comment section down below. All right, you guys, I love you, and I'll see you next month. Bye, everybody.